Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a very cool new custom knife maker from the Czech Republic, and also one of his newest models that he actually released. This is a evolution of his original Tasca model, which was a larger flipper liner lock, and I came across this maker just browsing around Instagram, and I was really impressed with the stuff that he is doing and the different models that he has. He also produced some pretty cool fixed blades, and I came in contact with him, wrote him on Instagram, and we came up with a build that I would certainly like, and I want to show you the knife here. And now let's get into the knife itself. So this is the RH Knives Tasca 2, the brand new model that he has released. I believe he has only built a couple of these so far. He really likes to work with some very nice fancy carbon fiber with the different kind of colors in it. I believe he has used the jungle carbon fiber with like green and yellow. He has used this one and then the kind of red lava carbon fiber so far. This is the only one that sports the DLC on the blade as well as on the hardware so far. And first off, I will just tell you a little bit about the maker itself while you can take a look at this gorgeous piece by him. So these knives are made by RH Knife, which stands for Richard and Honza. Honza is the nickname of the main knife maker here, which is Jan Samek out of the Czech Republic. And he is building knives for about 6 years now. And I think he's really one of those sleeper makers that can get really, really big. His Instagram following is not very large, and I would highly recommend to check his Instagram out. He also has a Facebook group and a website, and everything will be linked in the description below. You can see here his email as well, and then his address, and the name is Jan Samek. The Instagram is just rh.knives. And on the back you see some other models that he makes, because he has actually quite a catalog of different models that he is making. And for that reason, it's certainly a great thing to take a look at his offerings. Also, his prices are very, very reasonable for the amount of handwork and CNC machining that goes into these knives. And I think he has a great eye for design. When you get the knives, you actually are getting this right here. So you have a very large, nicely done certificate of authenticity where he writes per hand the model, the lock construction, the steel that he uses, which is mostly RWL34 on his folders, but he is willing to work with the customer. He said he will work with LMAX, M390 and so on, the finish as well as the handle material. I don't know if this is actually carbon plate or something like that, but it certainly looks that way. But he doesn't really specify which kind of carbon fiber he uses. Then you have the date of manufacturing and his signature. Other than that, it comes just in a nice non-descriptive like a knife taco here. So very well done on overall presentation. And the prices on the Tasca model start at 500 for a base model. Base model means a standard kind of blade finish. I think he usually does a stonewashed blade and regular kind of carbon fiber liner lock, same custom bearings, same hardware, just not DLC. And the steel will also be RWL34 on the base models, and 70% of the models that he is offering on the Tasca 2 will be base models. And then there is the custom versions where you can actually specify what you actually want. Will be about 30% of his production on these folders, and there you can choose different handle materials, different steel, different finishes and so on. And he is really a guy that can pull off some very nice finishing work. Also, he is using Damasteel upon request. That will jack up the price a little bit. A regular version just adding Damasteel would cost you about $750, because Damasteel is certainly a pretty expensive material to work with. The goal behind the design of this gorgeous Tasca 2 model here was to evolve the regular Tasca, which was a very nice looking larger flipper model, to add a different kind of opening method in the mix, and also shrink it down a little bit. It was designed as a nice high quality EDC blade that is fun to fidget with and also fits well in the hand, and he certainly has executed on that. Because this is one of the first Tasker 2 models, he actually has already done some design changes. There will be some slight jimping on the backspacer here, which actually also is made from the same kind of side cut kind of piece of carbon fiber, but that is a change that he has already made to the Tasker 2 models. Now let's take a look at the specs of this gorgeous custom knives out of the Czech Republic. So we get an overall length on the RH Knives Tasker 2 of 20.5 centimeters or just under 8 inches, with a blade length of 8.7 centimeters or 3.5 inches, a blade stock of just at 4 millimeters. The steel on mine is RWL34. And then we have a handle length of 12 centimeters or 4.5 inches. We have a flat ground blade, the very nicely executed edge. This thing is crazy, crazy sharp. That's also why you see me wearing this Band-Aid. This has cut me twice already because the action is so smooth when you overcome that detent and it just falls onto your finger. So you have to be careful there for sure not to cut yourself on the closing with this great folder. You can also open it with your thumb, as you can see right there, even though you have that Band-Aid on. Then weight wise on the Tasker 2, we are looking at 4.27 ounces or 121 grams. So for a custom knife of this size and build, I think the weight is certainly not too heavy. It also doesn't feel very heavy because most of it seems to be very nice carbon fiber. It is a liner lock, a titanium liner lock that has a large and very substantial stainless steel lock bar insert in here. There's absolutely no lock stick. And you see this guillotines down very impressively, but still the lockup is absolutely perfect. As you can see right here, also centering perfection right there. You see here the lock bar cut out on this thick titanium liner. There are no skeletonization done on the inside here on the titanium liners. That could be a slight improvement to get the weight a little bit down if you would try to do that. Also, we have no logos on the blade. You see it's a sterile mirror polished DLC. On the DLC, it's not super mirror polished, so you can see some slight cloudiness in that finish, in comparison to something you see on a Rockstead, for example. Here you have a real mirror polish, absolute mirror finish. You still have the mirror reflection there, but you see there is a little bit of a cloudiness on that DLC. The DLC is one of the few things that this maker doesn't do on his own. There is a lot of handwork involved in building these RH knives. He also utilizes CNC machining, but the DLC is outsourced. I believe he also builds his own bearings. So these sport some custom bearings, and the action that he gets out of this is very impressive. But on the DLC, I would like to see maybe change the finish underneath to actually get a little bit a more polished kind of finish in the DLC. I could imagine that underneath it's not a perfect mirror polish. That's why you see that slight cloudiness in the DLC. Very nitpicky thing, but just something I noticed on this gorgeous DLC coated blade. Also here on the opening hole, you see the slight chamfer there. So it's very comfortable to open and use. Also, it's actually quite easy to use, even though it's a quite thin slot, but because it has a little bit of length, it's actually quite easy to open it with the thumb and with your index finger for a reverse flick. So we certainly managed to check that goal of having a fun fidgety knife that has multiple opening methods. Also, the flipper tab deployment here is very well done. How he integrates the flipper tab into that forward scallop he has done here, so it's a perfect and transition from the handle to the very small unobtrusive flipper tab. So the flipper tab is almost flush with the backside of your knife there. So nothing that will poke at things you have in the pocket there. Very well done here with this minimalist flipper tab that still works impressively well. As you can see, also no jimping on the flipper tab, but it actually is not needed because you really just grab a hold of the front part of your of your frame there and just pull back, and it works flawlessly. If you like to do a push button, it's also possible, but I think this was certainly designed to have as a light switch deployment, and that certainly works perfectly well, and the action is just amazingly smooth. I hope you can appreciate that. I just have to be careful so it's not going to fall with all force on my finger there, so I have to do it a little bit more careful than I have done it before, as you can see here. But the overall execution here, as well as tying the whole look together with the absolutely gorgeously done custom hardware, which still can be adjusted with a flathead screwdriver, in this very nicely done DLC finish. Also, the small hardware is Torx and done in a DLC finish. Then you have the anodized titanium liners and clip with the RH Knives logo. I would love to see just the RH Knives logo you see here in the back on the clip instead of writing everything out, but that is certainly something that he could change in the future. Retrospectively, I probably would have gone with a DLC liner as well as a DLC clip, because of course these anodized titanium parts take the oils of your hands, and you can see it gets a little bit bronzy and also looks a little bit of a like a fingerprint magnet there. The clip actually works quite well, so you can see good bendiness, nice large ramp. Also on the carbon fiber, there is no real traction there, even though we have some very nice CNC lines that actually provide a little bit of grip on the carbon fiber. On an otherwise pretty straightforward handle design, you see pretty simple handle design in turn, not a lot of finger grooves, nothing like that. But because you have some slight ridges milled into the carbon fiber here, that actually provides some good tactile feedback when holding the knife. As you can see here, for my small to medium hands, 7.5 sterile glove fits very well. Space for another finger. So I think from small to large hands, this would work quite well. If you have extra large hands, maybe you would need a lanyard, but there is no way to attach that lanyard here on this knife, which makes for a very nice and sleek overall design. But you're out of luck if you want to use a lanyard. Also, it's only a tip down, it's only a tip up right side carry, so no way to swap that clip around. But because these are custom knives, you probably could ask for the clip on the other side on your particular build. Also, the access to the liner lock is done very well. We have a chamfered liner lock, a cutaway with a nice chamfer here on the carbon fiber, and it's very easy to disengage that liner lock and close the blade. And in the closed position, this is one of the most attractive knives I have seen in a long time. You see everything flows together, everything fits very well. Nothing is really outside of the general shape of the knife. No large flipper tab, no large hump for the opening hole, but still everything works perfectly well on the Tasca 2 here, as you can see right here. So very, very well done overall. If you take a closer look at the blade, we can see a very nicely done symmetrical grind, very nice and thin behind the edge. The plunge grind is done okay, but you can see a slight smile at the back, so a slightly larger sharpening choil would have been nicer. Maybe start with the edge right there, then you have a good sharpening choil and you clear the plunge grind completely. Other than that, nice, almost full flat grind, super, super sharp. And the ergonomics on this knife, because you have such a standard straightforward handle, are actually super, super well done. You have a slight guard from that small flipper tab there. You have one finger choil in the front, and then your fingers just land on there. And the overall knife is a bit of a thick boy. You can see that here. So I think this is over half an inch in thickness. Nicely contoured and rounded carbon fiber with some nice swedges at the end, and that means this almost feels like a fixed blade handle. Very, very comfortable, very, very hand filling, and certainly a knife you could actually use for some pretty heavy work. I believe most people won't use it for it because it's just too gorgeous, but it's actually a very, very comfortable knife in the hand. and just an absolute joy to handle and use. And now let's take a look at some size comparison so you can get a feel for the size in every dimension of this folder. As I said before, the Poco clip actually carries quite well, so it's not a hidden hardware Poco clip, it's a standard 3D mil titanium clip and carries about like this. So let's do our standard kind of size comparisons that we do here on the channel. We have the Shirogorov knives F95 and L, and you can see that F95 is quite a bit larger than the Tasca 2x RH knives from Jan Samek, and then we have the Neon Zero, and it slots in pretty nicely between those two sizes, so slightly larger than a Neon Zero and slightly shorter than an F95. So it's certainly on the larger end of an EDC folder for me with a 3.5-inch blade. Then if you take a look at the thickness, you can certainly appreciate quite a bit of a difference here in comparison to the Neon Zero right here, which is quite a bit of a more slender knife in the pocket. Then we have our regular kind of benchmark blades. We have the Benchmade full size bug out with aftermarket micarta scales, and then we have the Para 3 by Spyderco, also with aftermarket micarta scales. You can see it's larger than both of them. Here we can also do a good thickness comparison, and you can see it's quite a bit thicker than a Para 3. In the closed position, we can do it maybe even a bit better. You can see thickness is certainly a thing you have to keep in mind. Great in hand, but you can feel it a little bit more in your pocket there. And then we have some other comparisons to show you the knife I showed you before. This is the Rockstad Coup, a smaller Rockstad model, very close in overall design to the Shin, which has unfortunately been discontinued, but you can see size-wise quite a bit larger. And once again, another example of a great mirror polished DLC blade, something you don't see very often on any knives actually, so that is certainly a great feature on this particular one. Then some other knives I wanted to show the Tasca 2 against is, for example, here the Spyderco Spidey Chef. These are very close in overall size, much different in the hand because here we have a very curvy overall design. This is pretty much straight, looks a little bit like a fighter jet or something, but you can see in terms of size, these are very close, also in terms of actual cutting edge. And then I have some customs to show you here, one of my absolute favorite customs. This is my Skiff Knife Works or Skiff Blade Works Drifter, and these are also very similar, also a great CNC machine shop. These are US made, this is made in the Czech Republic. Then also a great US made knife with a hole opening is the Roosevelt by OZ Machine Company, as you can see here. And then the last thing I have for you is a Belgian knife. This is the Tour by Simon Strikers out of Belgium. So you can see pretty much close to the top ones, certainly larger than a OZ Machine Company Roosevelt. This is my early Roosevelt, this is number 43. So I hope you could get a good feel for the sizing here on the RH Knives Tasca 2. And I am really impressed with this knife, especially for a base price of $500 for a hand and CNC made knife from a very small time maker. So he is producing around 80 blades a year, which is very small in terms of numbers. And when you get an RH knife, you certainly get something that the maker took the time to absolutely perfect. It is perfectly centered. The action is just an absolute dream. It's absolutely perfectly sharpened. Just that little sharpening joint there could be an area of improvement. But also the blade is just an absolute joy to use. It's a great option of carbon of DLC. He also does some other great finishes. An absolutely gorgeous overall design on the Tasca 2. I certainly am preferred over the Tasca 1. I think this is a very great, unique overall design that certainly stands out. And with the materials that he is able to offer and to work with, I think for the prices that he asked, these are certainly a bargain in the terms of a custom knife. So RH Knives out of the Czech Republic, go check them out. I will link everything in the description, website, Facebook, as well as Instagram. And I hope that he gets quite a bit of recognition out of this video, because I think this is a knife maker you should absolutely check out. And if you're new into the custom knife world, this is certainly a great way to start. Amazing value, amazing action, great overall design, and just a knife maker you love to support. Great guy to talk to on Instagram, great guy to interact, just overall great maker and a great product. So this is my review of the Tusker 2 by Jan Samek from RH Knives, a great custom knife maker out of the Czech Republic. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Follow me on Instagram at 780_knife_reviews. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.